So we are going to prove an equation for the error of an nth order Taylor polynomial, namely that f of x minus the nth order Taylor polynomial evaluated at x, where our polynomial is centered around a, is equal to the integral from a to x of the n plus 1th derivative of f evaluated at t times x minus t to the n over n factorial dt. And right here is the sum for that nth order Taylor polynomial. We want to prove this for all integers greater than or equal to 0. And since we're looking at integers, it's a good idea to try proof by induction. In this case, our least integer is n equals 0, so we're going to use that as the base case. If we plug in the value of 0, we're going to get f of x minus, first we want the 0th order Taylor polynomial here. That's going to be this sum from k equals 0 to 0, which means really we're just plugging in the value of 0 to the inside here since we just have that one term. That means we're going to have f, the 0th derivative evaluated at a, over 0 factorial times x minus a to the 0th power. That's going to equal, on the other side, the integral from a to x of, right here we have 0 plus 1 is 1, so we just have f prime of t times x minus t to the 0 over 0 factorial dt. Now, if we take a look at the different terms here, we have f of x minus, 0 factorial is 1, so this part doesn't matter. Anything to the power of 0 is 1 for a non-zero base, so we just have right here the 0th derivative of f, which is the function itself, evaluated at a. On the right side, we're looking at the same thing. 0 factorial is equal to 1. Any non-zero base to the power of 0 equals 1. So we're just left with the integral from a to x of f prime of t dt. And this equation should look very familiar because we've all taken calculus, and this is one of the forms of the fundamental theorem of calculus. The integral from a to x of f prime of t dt equals f of x minus f of a. Because of that, we know that this equation is definitely true, and because that's equivalent to our formulation of the n equals 0 case, we have proved the base case, and now it's time to get to the inductive step. So here I've written out the beginning of our inductive step. We're going to assume that this proposition is true for some value n, and that means I've just taken this expression we have here, substituted this sum in for the nth order Taylor polynomial, and then put our little n in here. We want to get from this equation to the exact same thing, except everywhere we have an n, we see an n plus 1. In order to do that, we're going to start on the right side with this integral, and we're going to do an integration by parts. We want to get this derivative from n plus 1 to n plus 2. So we are going to do integration by parts with u equals the n plus 1 derivative of f. That way our du is going to be f n plus 2 of t dt. So we have that order of the derivative that we're looking for. That means our dv is going to be everything else, so x minus t to the n over n factorial dt. In order to get v, remember that we are integrating with respect to t. In this case, x is a constant. It's the value we plug in at the end. That means here, we're actually looking at a negative t integrating with respect to t. When we integrate this, if we did, for example, a u substitution, we would have to get a negative coming out of that du, which means our integral is going to be negative x minus t to the n plus 1 over, if we do the power rule, we're going to divide by n plus 1 times n factorial, which is n plus 1 factorial. And now we have all the information we need to actually do our integration by parts. That means we're going to get that this left side is equal to uv is going to be f n plus 1 of t times a negative, I'll put out in the front here, x minus t to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial evaluated at the bounds, x and a. Then we're going to have for integration by parts a minus, but then we have another minus here, so that will become a plus. The integral from a to x of our du here is f n plus 2 of t times x minus t to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial dt. So this integral that we have here is exactly what we need for our inductive hypothesis, but we need to take a look at this part over here to see if we can make it look like the rest of the sum that we want. If we plug in the bounds here, notice the upper bound is x. And if the upper bound is x, when we plug that into this polynomial here, we're going to get x minus x to some power, which means 0 to some power, which gives us 0. So the upper bound is actually going to cancel out. That's going to be 0. We're only looking at the lower bound. And if we plug in the lower bound, we're going to have to subtract. So this minus is going to just become a plus, since we have two negatives. So we have f n plus 1 of a times x minus a to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial plus that integral that we had before. Now on the right side of the equation here, this first term is exactly of the form that we want for this sum. If we put k is equal to n plus 1, we're going to get exactly the thing that we have here. And that means that if we take the equation f of x minus this sum equals this term here plus the integral, and we subtract this term, the result that we're going to get is f of x minus the sum from k equals 0 now to n plus 1, with this last term when we subtract it over here. This must equal that last integral that we had over here, and we'll write it in a form that proves the inductive hypothesis. The integral from a to x of, for this derivative, n plus 2 is the same as n plus 1 plus 1, evaluated at t, times x minus t to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial dt. This right here is exactly p of n plus 1, the thing that we want to prove for the next integer up. And therefore, by induction, we have shown that this equation is true for all integers. So that is the integral form of the error term for an nth order Taylor polynomial. This gives us an exact expression that tells us how close is that polynomial to the original function f of x. And this can often help us by providing information about how accurate are our approximations.